So one thing that's super annoying is dealing with technical issues when you're live streaming or recording. And in today's video, I'm going to be talking about the Elgato Cam Link. Now, I actually have been streaming here on YouTube for quite some time, and I recently got a new PC and transferred over all my OBS settings and all that good stuff. And I started streaming like normally, and everything was going good until I started getting a frozen camera screen about an hour and a half, 2 hours into my stream, which is very annoying, especially if you're live streaming to an audience. Not that I have a big audience or anything like that, but if you guys want to, you know, join the little community that we got going, make sure you guys subscribe, hit that bell notification. I really would appreciate it. Of course, like I said, this is a gaming channel and I play a variety of games. But besides that, back to the issue. Yeah, my camera has been freezing and it's very annoying, and I've looked all over the internet for quite some time and didn't find a fix for it, but now I actually did it, which is pretty easy. Most likely, if you guys are, you know, recording videos, streaming, you have all this stuff already ready to go, even what I'm gonna about to show you that will actually fix this issue. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys do, make sure you guys hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you guys are new, and without further ado, let's get into the content, shall we? All right, guys, we're right here on my PC. Now, what you want to go ahead and do is open your Elgato 4K capture utility right here. And this will open up, and right here on the top right gear, you want to make sure you guys hold control and open up the preferences right there. And this menu will come up. You have the camlink or the game capture HD if you guys have one connected. But make sure you guys hit that camlink. And usually, of course, first make sure you have the latest firmware updated. And if you guys are good with that, this USB transfer mode is set to automatic. That's how mine is, and pretty sure yours is like that. And I don't know if that was definitely causing the issue. I definitely thought maybe I had too many things plugged into my USB ports that I made some space and it still happened. And I looked more into it and found out that this might be the problem. I changed the setting and it started working again. So right here, from automatic, change it to isochronous. And ever since I changed it to isochronous, it's been working perfectly. I went 5 hours straight the other night and I had no problem, finally, thankfully. So make sure you guys change this setting and you guys should be good to go. You guys can cancel it, exit out. And of course, my camera froze because I went ahead and messed with it. So let me just actually fix it right here real quick for you guys. So bam, bam. Deactivate, activate, and boom, there it is. It's fixed. Obviously, it got frozen because I went in there and tried to mess with things right there. But yeah, pretty easy fix, guys. That should do it, and hopefully it fixes it for you guys. If it does, make sure you guys hit that like button. Let me know in the comments if it did for you so we can help out others, of course. And yeah, guys, I'll catch you guys on the next one. Take care. Peace.